my tail is one of the first things I put on right after my belt. I would have to say I was about 14 when I discovered the fandom. There's a lot of negativity towards furries on the internet, so I thought it was something to be ashamed of. It really took me a while to embrace in my daily life and off the internet that this is a part of who I am. This is Maxie the raccoon. I taught myself how to do suits, and ever since this guy, I've been hooked on making them. Any and every excuse to put on my suit is a valid one. The thing that a lot of people don't realize about these is that they're art. It's really hot, but it looks really good, not gonna lie. You know, the moment you put it on, you're a completely different person. You can do things that you never would have imagined doing. Ever since I was a little kid, I've had a lot of difficulties that I think most other kids haven't dealt with. I was bullied a lot as a kid. I was always the fat kid in my class. I liked to do what my mom told me, and I was ostracized for that. I went to 5 or 6 different schools throughout elementary and high school. And when I was 11 years old, my dad got sick with cancer. And before my 13th birthday, he passed away. So, you know, for a 12-year-old kid, that's just, you know, the earth shattering. The world falls apart. For years, I didn't recover. I didn't know how to come back from that. I started having, I guess, hallucinations. It started as really terrifying stuff, quite honestly. Demonic voices and the air tearing apart, and it was pretty scary. But I also started seeing this bear, this beautiful cinnamon bear, and it started as just seeing her off in the distance and thinking, oh my god, there's a bear in the city. I hope nobody shoots her. And it got to the point where she was almost like a guide for me. You know, sort of like an inner voice. Last December, I was brought into the hospital and diagnosed with borderline personality disorder. While I was waiting to be processed at the ER, I was talking to my ex-girlfriend, and she ended up breaking up with me. And a grand total of one of my friends actually ended up coming to see me. So once I got out, I realized I had to stop hiding part of who I am. I actively began searching for the community here in Vancouver. A big part of my life is furry. As strange as that sounds, but it's always so much easier to connect with people who are like you and have the same interests. I've met some of the best friends I've ever had, thanks to the community. I don't know where I'd be without them.